Welcome to the Living the Dream podcast with Curveball. If you believe, you can achieve. Welcome to the Living the Dream with Curveball podcast, a show where I interview guests that teach, motivate, and inspire. Today, I am joined by author Debbie Adams. She is on her second book. It's called Divine Promises. It's an autobiography about her life and how faith in God has helped her. So we're going to be talking to her about her story and her books and why she got into writing. So Debbie, thank you so much for joining me today.
Well, thank you for having me on your show.
Why don't you start off by telling everybody a little bit about yourself?
I was born and raised in Middle Tennessee, and I grew up on a farm. And as a child, I used to love to climb up in the barn loft with all the hay and the cows and God overhead. And I would read books, and sometimes I would even write little stories, whatever popped into my head. I grew up reading books. My dad is an avid reader, and to this day, I still read a lot of books. And I believe that it was God way back when that put the plan in action for me to become an author and, you know, start writing books. And I started writing books a couple of years ago, and God impressed on my heart that I had a testimony to tell. And so I had no idea how to even start about writing a book. And so God opened the door for me to go to California with a friend that I follow on Facebook. And she had a book writing retreat for 3 days. And so, she gave us all a lot of information and just the basics on how to write a book. And then I came back home, and it was in August of 22 that I wrote my first book, and I self-published it on Amazon. And so this year, God impressed on my heart that I need to talk about how faithful He has been in my life. And so I got a publisher, and I found him through my California friend, and he's really good, and he has helped me learn a lot more things about book writing as far as marketing and doing podcasts like this show. And different areas like that. And so my book is about the promises of God. And there are maybe 8,000 promises in His word. I'm not really sure how many, but I would guess about 8,000. And so I just take 10 of His promises, and I talk about what the promises are. And I show how those promises have been faithful to me in my life.
Well, tell us how you came up with the name Divine Promises?
Yes. God gave me that book title. And, we as humans promise, we can make promises to, you know, other people or family, friends. And sometimes we'll keep them, sometimes we won't. But, if something comes up, then, you know, we'll have to cancel on whatever we promise we're going to do. But I show in the book how God's promises, when He makes a promise, He doesn't decline on His promise. He is faithful and true. And He'll always come through on whatever promise, you know, it is. And my most favorite promise is the one where He says that He will never leave you nor forsake you. And that has held true with me throughout my entire life.
Well, tell us about your first book. that you published? Because I know this is your second book. So tell us about what the first one is about.
The first one is called Unlocking the Code to Bliss, and it was just a it's just a book to get my name out there, to get people to recognize, that I'm an author. And I basically use God in that book as well, because I talk about how God has created our bodies, and I talk about how to have a healthy lifestyle, not necessarily from dieting, but the way we eat, because I mean, I am one that loves sugar and, anything sweet. And I had to do a lot of research on that book, and sugar, processed sugar, is what's bad for you. Just, original sugar, from fruits that you get out of the garden or whatever, that kind of sugar is good for you. But the processed sugar, that is bad for your body, because it slows down everything in your body, and the way God created our body to work, everything needs to work in motion. And when you're putting something in your body that will slow it down, that's what I talk about in that book. And and then I give examples, like how I did in my life, in order to get to a healthy lifestyle. Because I used to be, tired all the time. I didn't want to do anything. But I was drinking like five Cokes a day loaded with sugar. So, that had a lot to do with it. And so with the Unlocking the Code to Bliss, I talk about, how I eat, fruits for breakfast. I'll eat a salad for lunch. And I like to get outside, and the sunshine is good for your body. I mean, it increases your vitamin C, and a lot of people, nowadays say that, the sun's not really that good for you, but as long as you don't, spend a whole lot of time out there where you're, like in the summertime where you would get sunburned or something like that, just getting the sun rays, to touch your body, and just walking barefoot in your backyard, stuff like that. And so that's what I talk about. And then how God created our brain is connected to different parts of our bodies, and it tells like your stomach to digest and how to digest, after you had a good meal, and just different stuff like that.
So, talk about what impact you want your first book to have on the listeners and what impact you want your second book to have on the listeners when they read them.
The first book, for anyone that is, like I was, lack of energy, you can read my first book, Unlocking the Code to Bliss, and I believe that it will help you to get more energy, where you're going to, wake up in the morning and be glad for another day. And then my second book, it's more involved with my testimony. Both books have, I talk about God in both books, because God is my life. And the second book is more about how he has done things in my life, how he has been true, how he has been faithful. But both books kind of go hand in hand together.
So you talk about the divine promises. You say there's like 8,000 of us, 8,000 of them. Tell us some of your favorite promises and why they are your favorite promises.
Okay. The promises that I talk about is the promise of redemption, restoring brokenness, the promise of provision, meeting every need, the promise of protection, finding security in God, the promise of guidance, navigating life's path, The Promise of Strength, Overcoming Challenges. The Promise of Peace, Tranquility in Chaos. The Promise of Healing, Restoring Wholeness. The Promise of Love, Embracing Unconditional Love. And the Promise of Eternal Life, Hope Beyond the Present. That is the 10 promises, the 10 chapters in my book. And I've got a story for every one of these. But probably my favorite, I don't know that I really have a favorite, but probably the one where I mentioned before, but it's, I didn't include it in here, but where God says that he will never leave you nor forsake you. But probably my favorite would be the promise of peace, because God will give you peace, you know, whatever you are going through. And if you are thinking about going down a road, you know, that you think it's going to be good for you, and but God knows what's ahead, and he, you know, knows that it's not going to be good for you, then anytime that I make any kind of decision and I pray to God, and if he gives me peace in my heart, I know that's the right road to take. And if I don't feel peace, I know that I need to go and ask him for, you know, what direction I need to go. And the Bible verse that I put, because I put a Bible verse at the top of each chapter. And for the chapter of the promise of peace, tranquility amidst chaos, I put the Bible verse of John 14:27. Peace I leave with you, peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. And like it says in the Bible verse, not as the world giveth, because, you know, everybody is looking for peace in the world. And, you know, sometimes we can find a small portion of peace, but with God, if you've got peace with God, you've got peace that is abounding all the time. And I guess another promise that I like is the promise of protection, finding security in God. And I'll give you a story on that one. And that's also, that story is also in the book. We were going through a tornado, and I was home with my dogs and my cat, and my husband had taken my car to get the oil changed or something. Anyway, he was at the car place. And so I knew bad weather was coming, but I didn't think about a tornado actually coming. And so somebody had called and told me that a tornado was coming in our area, you know, and so I thought, okay, I need to take cover. And so I went and got my dogs and my cat and my radio and, you know, my Bible. And I got in the biggest closet, you know, in our house. And so I started praying to God and to keep us safe. And it wasn't in there long. And I heard something that sounded like a freight train. And I've never been in a tornado before this. And I've always heard people say that a tornado sounds like a train. And so, you know, when I heard that noise, you know, I just prayed, you know, it's like, dear Lord, just keep us safe. You know what's going on the outside. And it wasn't a few seconds, the sound just disappeared. And so later that night, after my husband had came home and we were outside talking to the neighbor, and the neighbor said that he was looking out his window and the tornado was sitting right on top of our house. And then it just moved down the road. And so I told him, I said, that was the hand of God. I said, I was in there praying, and I was in my closet, you know, trying to stay safe. And I prayed, you know, for him to protect me, to keep me safe. And his hand moved that tornado on down the road. And so that the promise of protection, that is a really good one too that I like. And I mean, when you're in a tornado, that's just, and you know, and then it doesn't do anything, it goes on. You just never forget, you know, a life experience like that. So that's why I had to include that one in the book.
Absolutely. Tell us about any current or upcoming projects that you're working on that people need to know about.
I am currently working on my third book, and it's going to be called Straighten Your Crown. And it's not about a crown on your head, you know, like the queen in London, but it's the crown inside of your heart and your soul. And I'm not going to say any more details because I'll tell you what the book is about, but it will probably come out sometime next year, probably the first of next year. And it's gonna, I'll just say it's probably gonna be better than the Divine Promises. Because I strive to continue writing books, whatever God is, you know, gonna lead me to. And so he gave me that title a few months ago. And so I have been, you know, getting ideas about chapter titles and stuff like that from him. And so I'm almost to the point where I'm ready to, you know, just sit down and start writing.
Out your contact information so listeners can keep up with everything you're up to and purchase your books.
My books are, well, the first book is only found on Amazon. The second book and any future books are going to be on Amazon and any online bookstore. And it's my second book is also found at Chapters online in Canada for any, you know, Canada listeners or anybody that knows anybody in Canada. And it's at Amazon.com, Walmart.com, Target.com, Booksamillion.com, BarnesandNobles.com. And I have a website. It's called DebbieAdams.biz, BIZ. And you can, you know, check out my website. It gives all my contact information. If you want to email me, or there's also a place on there for you to send me a message, you know, and for any questions, you know, so you can either, you know, buy my books from Amazon or any online bookstores, or you know, you can send me a message on my website about buying my books.
Close this out with some final thoughts, maybe if that was something I forgot to touch on or you would like to talk about it, just any final thoughts you have for the listeners.
I would just want the listeners to know that it doesn't matter if you follow God or if you don't follow God, these two books are for any listeners, because the way I have written it, I write it as though I am talking to the reader. And so it will bless and encourage anybody that is a book reader. And I'm also going to be putting a audiobook on Amazon on both of my books for, you know, for people that would rather listen to a book being read than actually pick up a book and read it. And so that's coming soon too, probably within a month. And so I just want to say, you know, you will be encouraged by reading my books. So just go check out my books and grab you a copy. And leave me a review on Amazon and let me know what you think about my books.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, please be sure to check out DebbieAdams.biz. Pick up her books and keep up with everything that she's up to. Follow, rate, review, share this episode to as many people as possible, especially if they want to learn about the divine promises of God. If you have any guests or suggestion topics, cjackson102@cox.net is the place to send them. As always, thank you for listening. And Debbie, thank you so much for joining us and sharing your story with us.
Well, thank you. I enjoyed it.
For more information on the Living the Dream podcast, visit www.djcurveball.com. Until next time, stay focused on living the dream.